Okay, Vanessa here. So I have my garter carriage all put back together. It's nice and clean, well oiled, very well oiled, maybe. So I guess let's answer the most important question: does it knit? So first, I'm going to turn the power on. And then I'm going to press the memo button. I might have it wrong, but anyways. So, and then I'm going to pull the carriage over to my selected needles. The thread holder, the thread holder right here, it's not in a very good spot. So I guess if I press start and then stop, it fixes itself. My selectors, I have I've selected cast on, I selected this position and this position, and this should do a perfect e-wrap cast on for me. Should. There's always a chance I haven't done it right, but we will find out. Okay, so that is, let's see if I can get in closer, a perfectly executed e-wrap cast on. So now I'm going to pull back. Apologies for all the movement. Far enough that you can see both sides. Maybe just a hair more. Okay. And I am going to place my cast on comb first so I don't forget. I suspect somewhere I have a shorter one, but I'm still working on cleaning up accessories that came with it. Okay, for just one second, I want to get that out of the way so I don't accidentally hook it. The cover, because it's not the right one. Okay, that part's done. So I think I'm supposed to leave it there until I select my pattern. So I turn off memo and then step clear. I'm going to use pattern 547. Step, so position lights up, and then step again. Okay. And I'm going to set the counter for 50. I don't know if I'll go that far. Okay, I'm going to lift it and bring it back to the edge of my needles. And then this goes This goes to the back and forth position. And okay. So make sure I've got the slack out, and I don't seem to be hung up on anything. In the example in the book for this pattern, they start with 78, so let's just do that. And I have my tension correct for this yarn. Okay, let's push the start button and see what happens. Thank you. All right, so I stopped it there because I want to have the machine cast off. And it has to cast off from the right to the left. One thing is it's not counting down accurately for some reason. It's counting down perfectly fine, the counter, when it goes from right to left, but on left to right, unless I push the button over, it does not count down. So to prepare for casting off, I need to take and I'm going to use my transfer tool and hang the stitch from the previous row on the gate peg from each end. I can grab it. Almost. Okay, now I need to turn the machine off. I'm going to change the stitch direction to go in this direction. I don't know if it matters, but I'm going to set the counter to 1. And change to cast off. Or the C, and of course that button. So let's see what happens. Supposedly with the power off, I just hit the start button. If you leave the power on, then it will only cast off some of the stitches. It won't cast off all of them. Oh. Well, I don't know how it's gonna work. I forgot to take this thing off. Okay, start again. Well, we definitely have cast off. So there's our cast on, and there's our cast off edge. And our textured knitting. So once I figure out the counter, then I'm good to go. It does work without the counter, but because of, it's not very fast, so you kind of want to be able to use that countdown feature so that it stops knitting when it's supposed to. I mean, you can use your regular row counter to keep track of how many rows you've knit, but then you also kind of have to keep an eye on it. So I guess I'll fiddle with that a little bit more when I get a chance, but in the meanwhile,